Hello everyone, today I'll be talking about Google material icons and showing you two ways you can use them in your projects. So let's get into it. First things first, what are material icons? They are a set of simple, free-to-use icons which have been designed to be universally understood. You can find them by going to fonts.google.com/icons or by going to the Google Fonts page and then clicking on the icons tab. You can filter them by category. So for example, you might want to look at the different toggle options or navigation, and you can also filter by the style you want. So there are outlined, there are filled, and there are two-tone ones, and a few others. There are several different ways to add material icons to your projects, and I'm going to be showing you the one I find simplest, which is via Google Web Fonts. To do this, you simply grab the link from the documentation, which I'll post below, so that's right here, and you copy that into your HTML above the CSS link tag. This is so the material icons font is loaded before your CSS is read. Next up, you just need to select the icons you want to use and copy and paste the span tag provided by Google into your project. First off, I'll add this face to use as a marker on my form. So I just copy this and put that right in there. And then you probably have to clean up the indentation, etc. a bit. One thing to look out for is that you'll need to load the correct font according to the icon style category. So you can see that this one here is an outlined font, but currently I've only loaded the basic ones, which is why it's not rendering on the page. So to fix that, I simply need to just come in here and add outlined. And woohoo, my face has appeared. And to position it, I have created these IDs and I'm using the grid system. So I'll just put that in now, and it will magically go to the right place. So next up, I'll add this map pin to my form and give that one my ID as well. And finally, my envelope. You might be thinking it's easier just to copy and paste the span tags and change the name, which you can definitely do. But one thing to watch is that some of the icons have more than one word in their name. My personal favourite is this bakery dining one. And if you use those, what you need to do is have an underscore between the two words. So if you have just the space, like the name is displayed on the site, it doesn't render. So just watch that one. Now, as much as I like the little pastry, I think I should probably put it back to email for now. And then once you've added all of the icons you want into your project, you can style them however you like. So I haven't really changed them much. All I've done is just change the color to this darker gray. Now I should mention that labeling forms in this way isn't the best for accessibility because it's difficult for screen readers to understand these icons. And I probably wouldn't advise doing this in a production environment, but if you did want to use them in this way, one way to make it more accessible is to add an ARIA label like I have here. This is a label which can be read by screen readers but won't render on the page. Now I did say I was going to show you two ways of using these icons, and the second one is using them as placeholders in your inputs. And to do that, you also copy the link tag and add that to your style sheet. And I can then add my icon name as the placeholder. So I happen to know that the first one was called face. Now you'll see at first, this renders the name as text, which is not what we want. But to get around that, we just go into our CSS and we do input WebKit input placeholder. And then we change the font family to material icons outlined. And there we are. Our icon has now rendered onto our page. So this has altered the placeholder font family on Chrome, Opera, and Safari. You now need to add the selectors to do the same in Firefox and IE. So I will just copy and paste those in here. Now you might think it should be possible to have them in a combined selector like this, but it isn't. For some reason, they have to be separate. So just bear that in mind. If you did put them in combined and it's not working, that's why. So now I can add my placeholder icons for the location and email. So for the location, it was called room, and for the email, it was just called email. I should also mention that you can't have a material icon and a text in your placeholder. So for example, if I wanted to have the email icon and then the word email, that isn't going to work because you can only have one font family on your icon. So you have to choose between having a normally rendered text or the icon. And one other thing is you'll notice I have two Google Fonts link tags because I'm using the font family pop-ins, and then of course I've loaded the material icons. It's actually possible to combine these into one link tag to shorten out your code a little bit. So to do that, I'm going to comment out the text font one, and then I'm just going to copy the name of the Google font I'm using and place it right before the material icons, and then separate them with the pipe character. And then finally, I just need to switch this ampersand for a colon. And you'll see the icons are still loading perfectly, as is the font. So I can now get rid of my other link tag. And that's a bit shorter and easier to read. And if you want to add more than one style of material icon, so for example, if I want to use this lovely snowmobile, who wouldn't? You just simply need to add the icon font style separated again by the pipe character. And these are called material icons two-tone. And there we have it. That's how you add more than one style. So that's about it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. I'll add some resources in the description box below. Let me know in the comments which icons you're planning to use in your projects and which videos you'd like to see next. Thanks for watching, and please consider subscribing if you'd like to see more videos about CSS oddities and odysseys from me. See you next time.